Welcome to the fastest daf in town. Today, Masechtas Kedushin, daf Lamed Zayin. We are going to begin on Lamed Vav Lamed Beis by the new Mishnah. Let's see the Masnis. Kol mitzvah shehi tui ba'aretz. Anytime you have a mitzvah which is connected to the land, einanu heges el ba'aretz. So that law, any of those mitzvahs are only connected to Eretz Yisrael. V'sheinu tui ba'aretz, the Gemara is going to explain, that's no hegas ben b'aretz ben b'chutz la'aretz. However, there is an exception as we continue to Lamed Zayin Amud Aleph, a few exceptions. Chutz min arla v'kilayim. Says Rashi, she'afal pi she'tulis ba'aretz, even though the din of arla, not touching fruit for the first 3 years of a tree, or kilayim, forbidden mixtures, even though it's something connected to the land, nonetheless, Rashi says, no hagan af b'chutz la'aretz. Ha'arla halacha, and kilayim is b'divrei seferim, as we'll see later on. Rabbi Elazar omer af ha'chadash, also chadash, not eating from the new grains until the omer was brought. Now, what exactly does he mean by that? The Gemara is going to explain. It says the Gemara, my toya, my she'enu toya, ilei matoya. When it says it's something which is hanging or dependent on the earth, dechseba bia, because it says the word bia, entering the land. That's what it's referring to. For example, as Rashi says, kisavo, kiyabiyacha, v'she'enu toya, something which is not toya ba'aretz, is dolokse ba'biya, doesn't mention anything about entering the land, v'hari tefillin u'peter chamor. When it comes to tefillin and peter chamor, that it's brought down also in those, in that parsha, dechseba hen biya, it does say that language of biya, v'nohagen ben ba'aretz menuchotzaretz. So, tefillin and peter chamor, redeeming your donkey, are things that are noyig in chutz la'aretz. You have to wear tefillin in the United States. And it says bia there. So obviously that's not the reason. So Amrei Mihud HaChakamer. Kol mitzvah shehi chayves haguf. Any mitzvah which is on the body, on you as a physical person, that's no heges ben ba'aretz ben chutz la'aretz. That's what it means. Chayves karka eino no heges el ba'aretz. And he flipped it around. But again, what is a chayves karka? What is chayves haguf? So min hanimili. So how do we know that these are the dinim, the Tanu Rabbanan, Eila Hachukim, Eila Hamid Rashais. When it says Chukim, so that is referring to a Medrash, Vamishpatim is Eil Hadinim, Asher Tishmarun, and this is all taken from the beginning of Parshas, obviously, Eil Mishpatim. Zu Mishnah, Lasa Zu Masa, this is referring to actions. Now, why is Tishmarun Mishnah? Says Rashi, Shemavi Yodi Maisa. Because when you learn Mishnah, you learn Torah, it teaches you how to do things. Dechsib tishmer lasois. Ba'aretz. Yachol kol mitzvah kula noihi nohagin ol ba'aretz. It's unbelievable to have a havamina like that. That you would maybe think that only in Eretz Yisrael we do mitzvahs. Talmud loimer kol hayamim asher tem chayim. All the days that you are alive, al ho'adama, on the earth. So, I kol hayamim, all the days, if it says kol hayamim, you would think it's noig ba'aretz and chutz la'aretz. That's why it says ba'aretz. Echad shirib ha'kasev amiyat. So acher shirib ha'kasev amiyat, after the pasuk concludes, and then it becomes exclusive, selamad, come to learn, says Rashi. Al eiz mehem ha'kasev oimer kol hayamim, asher atem chayim al hadama. So, what is the including? What's the excluding? So, mamashi omer be'inyan. You have to look at the inyan, which Rashi says is echem yud gimel midaisi v'nilman mikan dechol chayves aguf nohagus af b'chutz la'aretz. So, you have to look at the context. As the pasuk says over there, abed ta'abdu neskol mekayim asa she'avdu sham v'gaymer, which has to do with the obligation of getting rid of avodah zarah. Now, avodas kachavim is something which is, you're worshipping a rock, you're picking it up, some type of statue. That is not connected to the earth. That's something which you, as an individual, even a non-earth, you don't own any land, you're still, it still applies to you. So af koil shehi chayves aguf nohagas ben ba'aretz ben b'chutz la'aretz. So we end up basically learning out from avodah zara that since it's within that discussion, and that pasuk of Abid Tabdun is there, talking about Avodah Zarah, which is a Chavis HaGuf, and that's something, therefore, we're going to say, based on this pasuk, is Noyig everywhere, because it's Kol Yomim Asher Atem Chayim Al HaAdama, since it says Al anywhere in the earth. So therefore, that's talking about Chavis HaGuf. Fine. Let's see. Okay, fine. It's a little bit of a question, but we'll wait. Chutz min ha'arla v'kilayim. So when it comes to arla and kilayim, that's the exception. That even though it's tzchoy ba'aretz, nonetheless it's noig bin ba'aretz min l'chutz aretz. So he boil who? Now then you had the seif of the Mishnah, Rabbi Elazar says also chadash. Now what does that mean? Rabbi Elazar will kula polig or chomer polig. Is he going lenient? Or is he going strict? What exactly does he mean? Chomer polig b'halchikamer. Maybe this is how you read the Mishnah. Tanakama says that chutz min arlam min kelayim de hilchas gemirula. Let's say it's a halacha moshe Sinai. The afa gab the ikal amem b'chavis akarkahi. Even though arlam and kelayim are connected to the land, and therefore you would think it's only noyig in Eretz Yisrael. So therefore, the chiddush is that even so. When it comes to Arun Kilayim, it's Noig also in Chutzarts. Aval Chadash Ba'aretz in, B'Chutzarts lo. However, when it comes to Chadash, they disagree that it's Dafkin Eretz Yisrael. My time of Moishev, it says you settled there, which is L'Acher Yerushi Yeshiva Mashma. After the inheritance and the dwelling, which is within the first 14 years, there was no Isser Chadash. Because it's only when it's Moishev was there an Indian of Chadash. But the first 14 years, there was no requirement of keeping Chadash, even though they were in Eretz Yisrael. Says Rashi, She'af ba'aretz on eschaibu. Even in Eretz Yisrael, they weren't obligated. Kol yudalad shana, all 14 years, shoy b'gilgal, when they're in that location. Shekavshu, when they were conquering, v'shechilku. It's really, as in Sefer Yeshua, there was 7 years of conquering, 7 years of division, until finally everyone's comfortably dwelling in their specific locations, and everyone recognizes what's theirs. So, interestingly enough, the mitzvah of Chadash, even though it's a land mitzvah, but it wasn't even knowing in Eretz Yisrael for the first 14 years after we settled, after we got there. Therefore, says the Gemara, "V'yaser b'lezel amemer af chadash nagi ben baretz ben b'chutzaretz." No, chadash is also something which we have to apply in chutzaretz. My time of Moishev b'chol machom shatam yoshim. It says Moishev. It doesn't mean once you're settled in Eretz Yisrael. It just means b'chol machom shatam yoshim, wherever you are. Which means even in chutzaretz, you have to keep the dinim of chadash. So therefore, in that case, you would read the Mishnah that Rabbi Elazar saying af chadash is being strict. Well, Dibble cool pole. Maybe he's going lenient. V'halkakamer. Tanakama. Chutz min arlam kilayim dehilchas gemirula. That they said, when it comes to arlam kilayim, so the din is that it's noyig everywhere. The kol shekein chadash. And even the Tanakama say that chadash, the din is that it is noyig in chutzorets. The moishib mikom mikol makoim or kol makom shatim yoshim mashma. So it's mashma in any place, wherever you are. Therefore, you've been in Chutzart. So maybe, even though the Tanakhama doesn't mention Chadash, but it doesn't need to mention Chadash, because it's a Dover Pasha Yubichayev everywhere Chadash, because it says Moishav. V'yaser b'lezer l'meimer Chadash ain't noig el ba'aretz. And Rabbi Elazar says, no, Chadash, he's more lenient, is not noig, except for an Eretz Yisrael. The Moishav achay Yishim Yishiva mashma. When he says also, he's just going on the first part. Says Rashi, it's going back on the ratio of our Mishnah, the beginning of our Mishnah, that anything which is tuli ba'aretz, and he says, I include chadash in that category. That's tuli ba'aretz, and since it's tuli ba'aretz, it's not noyig chutz aretz. So you could read it either way. Basically, the question is, what does Rabbi Elazar hold? Does he hold, when he says, Af HaChadash, is he saying Chadash is also knowing in Chutz Ha'aretz, or Chadash is not knowing in Chutz Ha'aretz? That's the question. So where says Tashma, Yom Rabbi Mantan, the Paul Gold Rabbi Elazar, who it disagrees with, Rabbi Shmuel, the Sanya. Anytime the pasuk says Moishav Enu El Achir Yishmi Yeshiva, Diyav Rabbi Shmuel, which means that it's therefore only knowing in Eretz Yisrael. And Rashi says this is Gabi Parshas Nesachim Koi. This is referring to the pouring of the wine. Skipping a few lines, it says Latina Nesachim Lebamos Sibor Vobamos Yochid. That the pasuk is only come to tell you regarding pouring the sachim for a bomas sibor and not regarding a bomas yochid. But on it says regarding Shabbos, it also says the word Shabbos. And nonetheless, of course, we know that it's noyig in all places. So how could you say that just because it says moishav, that anytime it says Moishav, it's only in Eretz Yisrael? Rabbi Kiva says, but we know that's not true, because Shabbos, it says Moishav, and of course it's knowing everywhere. Generally, Shabbos Kavachayim Rasya. The reason why Shabbos is obviously kept everywhere is from a Kavachayim. Ma mitzvah kalos nohagas men baretz men b'chutz la'aretz, Shabbos chamil l'kol shekein. It's a difficult Kavachayim, because what is considered to be a mitzvah kal, what's a mitzvah chomer, but certainly Shabbos is a mitzvah chomer because we have, for many reasons. Let's just say simply because there's a chil Shabbos is an isr skil, which is the most severe of all the death penalties, according to the Tanakhama. So therefore, the point is that when it comes to mitzvahs kalis, we have to do outside of Eretz Yisrael, then certainly a mitzvah chomer such as this, you most certainly would have to. Okay. So Shabbos, even though it does, you're right, even though it says Moishav, that would be an exception because there's a Kal V'chomer that contradicts that word. He said, who argues Shema Mino? Rabbi Elazar, L'chomer Polig Shema Mino. It must be that Rabbi Elazar is going strict, because Rabbi Shmuel is saying this opinion regarding that it's only Noyig in Eretz Yisrael. And now that that's what we just saw, Rabbi Shmuel holds, and it's Rabbi Akiva, but if we're saying that he also disagrees with him, Rabbi Elazar disagrees with his opinion, obviously it means it's not just in Eretz Yisrael, but it's also in Chutz Ha'aretz. So Michti, Rabbi Shmuel Hechakoi, Anasachim. So Rabbi Shmuel, he was talking about, as we talked about, the various libations, the pouring of wine on the Mizbeach. B'nesachim, as we continue to Lamed Zayin Mabeis, Bia U'moishav K'sibuhu. It's a little bit more of a problem to learn out from there, because it says Bia and it says Moishav, says Rashi. The Hechayof Minei Moishav B'lo Bia. How could you learn out a place where it says Moishav only without the word Bia? Dil Mahai Demifrash Be Bia Sa'aretzu, D'lo Boi L'meimer Kol Makam Shatim Yoshim Abo Moishav B'lo Bia. So maybe the only reason why, when it comes to the Sachem, it's Noig Ba'aretz, is Dafka, is because it has both languages of Bia and Moishav, which is Mashma. If let's say you have a place that says Moishav and not Bia, so then that in itself, of course, should be Noig B'chutzarts, which explains, again, when it comes to Shabbos, so it's not Akasha on Shabbos, because on Shabbos, fine, it says Moishav, it doesn't say Bia. So Hachem Elamid, to teach us, Shekol Machem Shnemer Bi U'moishav. Anytime it says both, Enanoig Ella Le'achir Yishiv Yishiv Adib Rabbi Yishmuel. So we see, again, Rabbi Yishmuel now is saying that it's necessary Dafka when it comes to saying both. Back in Rashi, V'chadash also Rabbi Yishmuel Lashmin, and interestingly enough, now Rabbi Yishmuel is teaching you D'chsibi Nami Bias Ha'aretz U'moshavois, that by Chadash it also says Bia in Moshavos, and therefore by Chadash, just like the Sachim, so therefore the din is that you it's Noig Dafka Ba'aretz. So Yehachi Yamal Rabbi Akiva Harishavish Nebra Ba Moshavos Yarmalay Shabbos Kavachimer he, you don't have to even come on to the Kavachimer, which we said before. Namely Anna, Biu Moshe Kamina. Maybe you need Bia and Moshe. The fact that you have to have both in order for it to be Dafka Ba'aretz. However, Shabbos, it only says Moshe, it doesn't say Bia, so you don't need a Kavachimer. The answer is you're right. Chada Ba'ad Karmalay. Chada Diana Bia Moshe Kamina. First of all, it's not a Kasha and Shabbos because it's Dafka if you have both Bia and Moshe, like Nesachim and by Chadosh. However, when it comes to Shabbos, it doesn't have that, so therefore it's not also in Chutzarts. But it does say Moishav, so maybe it should only be Noig, but Aretz nonetheless. No, Shabbos Kabachaymer he, as we said. So, but my Kamefahi, what exactly is this Machlokas? Either Machlokas is where they Makriv Nesachim libations while they were still in the Midbar. Bishmul Sabar. Rabbi Shmuel, who said Bia or Moishav, it's in Eretz Yisrael, Savor lo kir b'nesachim b'midbar. He held that it was not brought in the midbar. Says Rashi. It says V'yafka de'osid b'meluyim v'zasher tasel mizbeach, and it says nesachim by over there. So b'karben tzibur hu dehavi, in by the karben tzibur in the midbar. You're right. There was nesachim. Avol ha'yichidim lo neschayvim nesachim. So this is talking about, again, just to qualify a little bit better, that it's not talking about a carbon seabor, by a carbon yachid, that they did not bring nesachim, or there it says Rashi and neschayvu, they were obligated to bring nesachim to accompany their carbonos in the midbar. So that's the opinion of Rabbi Shmuel. Rabbi Kiva Savar, Kiva nesachim in midbar, they were mocker of them. Rashi again says we yachid be midbar. Mishikarvu l'rab. Skipping a couple lines. Kan l'huskru el mimnei b'meis b'mas yochid. Shehotur b'biyasan l'gilgul. That when it came to a b'mas yochid, they were allowed to go in, have a b'ma. Kol yudal shana uva kasav latin mesachim. Lahati on... Nesachim. Okay, my words a little bit blurred over there. So it's coming to tell you that when they were in Gilgal, those first 14 years, there was no Isser of Bamas Yachid, and there was Nesachim then. But the Machlokas between these two opinions is not what went on in Eretz Yisrael, but what happened before. Whether or not you had to wait until there was Biyu Moishav to be able to bring the Sachem. Now, Rekiva Sover, Kiva Nesachem in Midbar. He said that it was. Amr Abai. So, Hai Tanda Rebbe Shmuel, Mapik Me'idach Tanda Rebbe Shmuel. This Tanda Rebbe Shmuel can actually learn from another Tanda Rebbe Shmuel. The Tanda Rebbe Shmuel, another quote, Ho'ovanemer Biyois Batayra Stam. It says the word Biya in the Torah generally. Uperet Lecha HaKasa Be'echamehen. And then the Torah goes out of its way. Rashi says, Gabi Melech, by a king. It says, Rashi says, Kisavo Aretz, the Yerish to be Shavta, by Vermarta, Asimo, by Melech, to appoint the king. Once you're in Israel. So why does it exclude it? It comes to tell you, Perdo Chalkasa, by Echamehem, Lacher, Yerush, Vishiva, Avkol, Lacher, Yerush, Vishiva. So we learn out, just like the din of Melech, since you have Melech, which it tells you it's only after Yerush Yeshiva, so too when it comes to any other time in which it says Bia, that's only Lacha Yerush Yeshiva. V'idach. Therefore, again, that's an interpretation as to why it wasn't, when it comes to Nesachim also, it was not until Lacha Yerush Yeshiva, and not in Midbar. V'idach. Yishem Dehavi Melech Bikurim Shnei Kusumboin Ke'achad, V'chol Shnei Kusumboin Ke'achad, Ein Melamdin. Because in addition to Melech, also by Bikurim, it says V'hoi Kisavo, name of the Parsha, El Aretz, so it definitely says B over there. And it also says Yerushi B'Yeshiva. So therefore we say, when it comes to Bikurim, the bringing of the first fruits, the din also is that you have to wait until after Yerushi B'Yeshiva, until you're actually in Teretz Yisrael, not before that, and obviously not in Chutz Aretz. The point is, maybe it's Dafka when it comes to Melech and Bikurim only apply in Eretz Yisrael, after Yushiv Yeshiva, but not Nesachim, because it sneaks over in Keach, and you can't use a Mamatzinu, you can't use a Sadashal, you can't use a Mamatzinu, binyan from this. Okay. No, you still could use create a binyanav through a mamatz, make a mamatzinu, because both of them are necessary. Because if you only had one, you wouldn't learn out the other one from the other. Why do you need bikurim, and you wouldn't learn out bikurim from melech and the other way around? Because about a melech, about having a king, because of bikurim, having a bikurim because mishanil alter. When it comes to bikurim, you think it applies right away because it's something which you can derive benefit from right away because you can eat it. So therefore, you would think that Bikurim actually should not apply only after Yeshiva Yeshiva. Because the Bikurim, because of Melech, Havimina Melech, the Dark Lichvayish, will alter. The whole purpose of a king is to help conquer the land. So therefore, why would you wait until after the land's conquered to appoint a king? That's actually seemingly counterintuitive. You would want to have a king immediately, and that king is going to give us direction to know how to conquer the land. So therefore, these are two mitzvahs that one could not derive from the other, and therefore we learn out. Just like these two, Alach Yushiv Yeshiva, so too when it comes to Nesachim is the same din. Okay. The Idach, so Nechta Baruch Amon HaMelech V'lo Boi Bikurim. The truth is, all you need is king. Yana Amina, Ma Melech Delichvayish. Even though the purpose of the guy is to conquer, so you would think of me right away. Nonetheless, it's like Achi Yushiv Yeshiva because the pasuk goes out of its way and still says it's, we push it off. Bikurim will koshikain. So it doesn't believe this whole notion of yeah, but maybe because you get Hano right away. No, if a king, you definitely think you should have a king right away because you need him to help you fight a war. And yet we wait, so certainly Bikurim, you wouldn't think any differently. And therefore, you could have learned just one. And the fact that you mentioned two is coming to tell you it's Shnei Ksuvim Bo'in Keach Ve'in Melamdin. And therefore, maybe it's Davka there that you have to wait until after Yushiv Yeshiva. However, not when it comes to the Sachem in the Midbar. V'idach Yikasav Hachi Habamina Midid Havyachala. We say, not necessarily. You would maybe, if you didn't mention Bikurim, Bikurim is a food, where you get Hana right away, Mishanil Alter, but Chala is the same thing. Chala is something which you can derive benefit from right away, and it says Rashi, Da Hakol Moidim Shneschaibu Miad, you're chayv immediately, because the pasuk says, Bevoachem, and it's brought down the Sifri, Mishuna Biazumi Kol Bia Shibatayra, it's different. Shneber Bahen Kiviyacha, Ki Savoy, and Kanemer Bevoachem, Mikivan Shiboy, it means, from the time you come, the chayvu, the second you walk into Eretz Yisrael, you're now chayving in challah. To kamash malan. So therefore, the point is like this. Maybe, if it only mentioned melech and not bikurim, you still maybe would think bikurim is actually not noig achar Yushiv Yeshiva, because when it comes to challah, it's noig immediately, so maybe bikurim is also a food, should be noig right away. And bikurim, so when it comes to challah, for sure it's true. It's right away. When it comes to Bikurim, it's Lach Yushiv Yeshiva, because it's written that way. And it's written that way not to exclude anything else. But rather, you could still learn out Melech and Bikurim to teach us other things, including the Sachem. That was only Noyig after Yushiv Yeshiva. Okay. And also, again, to Matar Bamas Yochid while they're in Gilgal. So, one second. If it's true that when it comes to a chayvus aguf, any mitzvah that I have to do it no matter where I am on this planet. So, Moshe, the Kosovar Chanagam Shabbos is Lumli. Why does it say Moshe? That's just a curveball, as we thought. Moshe may have actually given us the Havamin to think that the mitzvah of Shabbos is only Nogan Eretz Israel. So it's Chsachdel Hamina Hoyel Uvinyana de Moadois Ksiva, because it's written in the same category of all the other holidays, Tiboy Kiddush Ki Moadois. You would think it needs Kiddush, says Rashi, Kiddush based in. For Noig Kiddush El Yehuda, and it was only Noig in Yehuda in this particular location, in Eretz Israel. Kamash Mulan. So that's not true. The din is, even though it says Moishav, So you would think, because the truth is, it is connected to Eretz Yisrael in a certain way, because when it comes to all the Moadim, which is written next to the Moadim, it does need Kiddush HaChodesh. But we know when it comes to Yom Tov, we say Mekadosh Yisrael v'Hazmanim, that the Yisrael do it. But when it comes to Shabbos, you just say Mekadosh HaShabbos. Hashem is Mekadosh HaShabbos. Shabbos Bereishis happens no matter what. You don't need to be Mekadosh. It's sanctified automatically. Moishev the Kosev Baruch Hu Gami Chelev Adam Omli. So you can ask the same Kasha. When it comes to the Isser of eating Chelev, fats, forbidden fats, and eating blood, it also says the word Moshe, but we know it's Noyg Bin Barts Min Chutz Arts, so why does it say it? So it's Sakna Min Hoyel Vinyana de Karbonos Ksive, it's written in the same area as the Karbonos, Bizman de Ika Karbin, so when there's a carbon, Nitzer Chel Vadam. Maybe that's when there's an Isser of Chel Vadam. Bizman de Leka Karbin Lo Kamash Mulon. You would think maybe when there's no carbon, that the din is would not apply. Question 2. So he says, by Shabbos, you would think you would have to sanctify in a base then. You would think it's not usher bizman the lake of carbon if there was no carbon. Okay. That's the tzrich. Okay. Moshe the Kasav Rachman Gabi Matzah Moralimli. So you can ask the same Kasha. Why does it say Moshe? We know that even outside of Eretz Yisrael, we eat matzah, we eat Moral on Pesach. So why does it say Moshe? Israel. Sakhdim in a Hoyal de Ksiv, Al Matzah Samarim Yachluhu, Bizman de Ika Pesach in Bizman de Lika Pesach Lo, Kamash Mulon. Because you would think that it's Dayig it's maybe only noyig in a place where there's a carbon Pesach. However, there's no carbon Pesach, then you would not eat it, right? Bizman the ika Pesach in bizman the lika Pesach lo kamash mulon. And we know this is true that even someone who's tamei, who doesn't bring the carbon Pesach, as we saw in Pesachim, is still mechuyev to eat matzah mor. Okay, fine. Maybe it could be a nidcha possible to Pesach sheni more, but the discuss is when, what, but. The reality is there's still an independent mitzvah of matzah and mar. So even though it says moishav, which could kind of give you an impression that it's totally on land or not totally on land, the point is that the reason why it says that to emphasize is to give them to tell you it's not true. It's even though you're b'chutzal arts, but you would maybe think it's not because here again because it's connected to the Karban Pesach. Okay. Fine. Look, this is actually a very good Rashi explains the three questions very nicely. Lumli kivanda chayvus agufi. Since these three mitzvahs of Shabbos, chel of Adam, and matz and mar are obligations on me, pshita no hegus b'chol moishavos. We know when it says moishav, it's knowing everywhere in all places. So why does he need to tell us? It's all in all places. Of course, it's in all places. Okay, so that's the chiddush. Okay, b'ya de kasev rachman gami tefillin de petach hamor lamli. So why does it, in fact, when it comes to tefillin and petach hamor, why does it say b'ya, which is mashma maybe pumfa kert, right? You would think maybe. It's dafka, as we said, maybe it's knowing only in Eretz Yisrael. We know it's not true. So, homa boy leil katanir maybe Shmuel asim mitzvah zu shmishvila tichanas arts. Do this mitzvah. Do these two mitzvos, namely tefillin and petach hamor. And if you do this tichanas arts, you'll enter Eretz Yisrael. Exactly. You have to think about why those two particular mitzvos. But there's something unique and special about tefillin and petach hamor. What is the link between those two seemingly unrelated mitzvos, but there's obviously a connection to doing those two mitzvos that then you'll be zeichet to go to Eretz Yisrael. Okay, we're going to stop there. Let's look at question 1. Elu mitzvos ksiva bahen bia. What are the mitzvos that are, it says bia? Benohogas bein ba'arts ben chutzarts. This could have been a question from before. Tefillin and petach hamor. TA 4. Be'elu mitzvos. So these are the mitzvos, ksiv bia, it says bia, for darshin and lach yushiv yeshiva l'kuli alma. And we say, it's even though it says bia, it's lach yushiv yeshiva according to all opinions, And that is, as we said, Melech and Bikorim. So let's just get this down. TA4. When it comes to Melech, let's see. You have Melech Ubikorim. So Melech Ubikorim, we know for sure, according to everyone, is Leach Yushabi Shiva. The Ezu Mitzvah Siv Bia Vedarshina Miyad, which does it say Bia and it is immediately? That is Chala. That's also Ladivri Hakol. Let me just find that. Because when it comes to Chala, Rabbi Idach Ikosiv Hachi Havamina Amida Dehavia Chala Kamash Mulan. So Chala is noig right away. So again, we said Bikurim, when it comes to Bikurim and Melech, that's noig only Acher Yishuv Yeshiva. However, when it comes to Chala, it's right away. Elu mitzvah sksiv bia v'darshina asei mitzvah zu shebishvil atichan es la'aretz. And this is a really hard question. There's a lot of stuff here. But that, of course, is tefillin and petach hamor. Okay, so let's just get these three parts. There's a three-part question. And I only got two-thirds of it right, which is still pretty good. It's a hard question. The first question was, where do we find that it says the word bia, but nonetheless, it's not, it's, and it's noig only after Yerushalayim Yeshiva, Melech Bikurim. That's a little kuli alma. What mitzvah does it say bia and it's right away? It doesn't exactly say bia. It's the language, as Rashi said, because this is bevoachem, so it's miyan. It's more of a language of going right away. And then the mitzvahs that says bia and we darshan asim mitzvah zu shebishvila techanas aretz is tefillin and Peter Chamor. Okay, let's look at TB5. B'ma nechahu tanakama of Rebbe Lezer im chadash noig chutz la'aretz olo. What exactly is this machlokas? This is, again, a little bit more difficult question, more intricate into what we were discussing, but this is the point. E moshavos hakasa b'inyin kol makam shatim yoish b'mashma lo'yach yirushil v'yeshiva mashma. Okay, so actually, they wrote it pretty simply. So when it says Moshavos, does it mean in all only after you're dwelling there? Or is it Mashma, therefore it's Acha Yerushim Yeshiva? Or is it Komakam Shatem Yoshim? Adkan.